everyone. Welcome to Toward a Quality of Life here in the month of March on a somewhat pleasant afternoon. Yes, coming to you from the Roxbury studio of BNN-TV. Now, before I start with what I'm going to talk about, which is more about the deplorable, alarming, sad, and discouraging situation in Washington, D.C., and for our country, so much so that you'll notice, usually I bring you topics of environment, philosophy, physics, psychology, but I keep on harping on the politics and on what's going on with our beloved country because it is such a stark and startling situation. Last time that I gave a lecture about some of these similar issues, it was pointed out to me that people may like to know where I get my information. And anything that I say to you can be checked out for its veracity, either in actual print in paper media or books, or it can be seen on the internet. And one of the easiest ways to see what I'm talking about on the internet would be just to Google. And if you Google things and have practice at it, you'll notice that using the right keywords in the right sequence order, you'll start to get a flavor for it, brings you better and better results as you have practice and know more how to do it. Otherwise, some of the media that I pay attention to or peruse to find out my information would be a lot of liberal newsletters and media outlets, as well as conservative ones. And these would be some outlets such as Huffington Post, the Wall Street Journal, the New York Times, the Los Angeles Times, Real Clear Politics, Politico, which is on MSNBC every day talking about its news events, and World News Daily. So those are things that you can use, too, to find out what I'm talking about. And believe me, you almost have no right to vote. You almost have no right to think or have an opinion if you don't really know what's going on and you're just going by some superficial appearance and superficial lies. Now, I'll tell you something, too, before I begin, which kind of fits in with government and what government is doing and so on. I know many people from the country of Haiti. And, of course, they had that horrible earthquake recently. And then a while later, we had the earthquake in Chile. And when we did, one of the people I know from Haiti saw me and said, "Boy, did you see now another earthquake?" And I said, "Yes." And she said, "Why do you think we're having so many earthquakes?" And I said, "Well, because I believe possibly that a lot of the underground bomb testing and other kind of underground shenanigans that go on with our military and research people here and around the world could possibly be having an effect on the earth becoming unstable and shook up, so to speak." So the person said to me that in Haiti, we believe that it was an earthquake bomb. In other words, a bomb that was sent to make an earthquake. And perhaps an earthquake as in a test to see how it would be, or perhaps to make an earthquake. So I thought, no kidding. So I went to Google, and I Googled earthquake Haiti earthquake bomb. And lo and behold, we do have bombs, and as do other countries, that are meant to create earthquakes, to go deep into the ground and do destruction from that angle. And the idea is, some people are believing that this earthquake bomb was being tested to possibly be used in Iran, because you know that there's a big discussion the world over to not allow Iran to get nukes, which they believe they're trying to do, to nukes in the sense of not just nuclear power for energy, but nukes that would be bombs and be able to threaten other people by having them. So, and also some of the articles pointed out that one of our military top persons happened to be in Haiti during that time and stated this might be the reason he was there should something go awry with this bomb. And another thing this person told me why people felt that way was because the extent of the damage, she told me way more than an earthquake, the breadth and the width of how much it interfered with. It wasn't localized, so to speak. And also that the people reported before the earthquake struck itself, before the roar or noise of the earthquake, people reported that all the water drained away from the shore and the fish were left. And then the earthquake happened, which seemed very strange to some of the people of Haiti. So this is something interesting, kinds of things to keep in mind that happened that are not really easily understood. And this reminds me, I'll bring up some others that are also challenges that I don't necessarily spend time wondering about it or getting into conspiracy theories about it or accusing people about it. But they are interesting phenomena that people, you know, would find curious and challenging to know about. Another one that is somewhat in a similar vein is what happened in New Orleans during Katrina. You most well have heard that some people who lived near the levee when the levee broke swear that there were bomb noises going off for the levee to be breaking before the levee broke. The bomb happened and the levee broke. And I think, I'm not sure, that Spike Lee made a documentary or a movie about this. So that's another interesting thing. And the theory there is that they knew the water was going to overtake the city and they wanted to save the most commercial parts more productive parts, so to speak, economically, and to let go the parishes that were closer to the levee by doing what they did. So it's another interesting thing. Then, of course, we have 9/11. And many people have many questions about what happened at 9/11, and I have no idea why or how 9/11 happened totally, and I'm not sitting around accusing or thinking conspiratorially, but it's interesting to note how many things by reasonable intellects have been challenged and questioned as to why they happened the way they did. For example, the way one of the buildings collapsed, some engineers of repute have said it's impossible for this to have happened from an airplane hitting it. The dynamics, the physics of how it happened just didn't add up, according to them. Another thing is, I remember seeing a documentary done by a very intelligent Hispanic guard custodian who worked the bottom floors and probably the whole building of the World Trade Center. And he said, he described in intricate detail what he was relaying was that there were bombs going off before the building was impacted and had what we saw on television. There were bombs going off below, and I can't remember the details of the story, but he was trying to get out what he experienced in advance of what came to be seen as a plane explosion into the building. Also, we have a system, NORAD, that when things are going awry in the skies, that the military sends out jets to go alongside the planes that are a problem, possibly bring them down and so on. And NORAD was called into action on that morning as the plane left Boston, I guess. Did they all leave from Boston? I can't quite remember. No, I don't think so. But anyway, instead of coming immediately when they were ready to take off, they were delayed.